So good morning guys, in previous lecture we have covered the concept of motivation, okay, and we have started the motivational theories. Okay, so we have studied four theories, that is fear and punishment theory. Second one is your reward theory, third one is your Maslow's hierarchy theory, hierarchy needs, and last one is your carrot and stick theory. Okay, so one by one we will discuss these all motivational theories. Okay, so first one is what your fear and punishment theory. So actually in fear and punishment theory, the managers will develop a strategy to force the people to work by threatening to punish or dismiss them or cut their rewards if they did not work well. Okay, it means what? So managers will tell the people, or managers will direct all his employees to complete their work in a given time or to complete their targets, which will be completed in a given time. Okay, and if these targets will not be completed in a given time, then he will dismiss the employee on the basis of this target. Okay, so depending on the manager's strategies, all employees will going to complete their works in a given time because of the dismissal of the job. So this is nothing but a fear which is implemented in a mind of that employee. Okay, so due to this fear, he will complete all the given targets. So, and this philosophy, actually fear and punishment philosophy, it is characterized by thinking of aggressiveness and authorities managers. Okay, so thinking of aggressiveness should be there to complete the work from the employees. Okay, and there was a tight control and rigid supervision over the workers from the managers. Okay, so fear and punishment theory, it means manager will develop a strategy how to complete the given targets in a given time from the employees. So he will dismiss the employee if the target is not completed by the employee, and due to this fear, the employee will complete their targets. Then second one is what your reward theory. So this reward theory, it is nothing but this theory tried to establish a direct relationship between the efforts and rewards. Means what are the efforts taken by the employees, they will be rewarded. Okay, so if the targets or all employees will complete their targets in a given time, and they will improve the product, if the employees will improve the productivity of the organization, then a reward system should be there, and this reward system should be there from by the organization. Okay, so the basis of piece rate system of the wages, it means what? So reward system, it should be a monetary or it should be a non-monetary. Okay, so in monetary the rewards is given in rupees, and in non-monetary the rewards is given in a types of rewards. Okay, so based on the standard, manager should decide on degree of rewards and penalties. Okay, so it means what? The reward theory, it is based on the standards that the manager should decide on degree of rewards and penalties. Okay, so by using this reward theory, manager will complete their work in a given time, or manager will try to complete, all the employees should complete their work in a given time. Okay, so this is about your reward theory. Then next, third one is what your carrot and stick theory. So carrot, it is nothing but we need to give some money. Carrot, this theory suggests a combination of both rewards and penalties for motivation. It means what? If the all employees are completing their work in given time, then they will get reward, and if the employee will fail to complete their work in a given time, then some penalty should be there for that employees. Okay, so this carrot and stick theory, it is based on reward and penalty system. Okay, and this is based on the strategy of putting carrot in front of the donkey and hitting it with the stick so it has to run. Okay, so putting some carrot in front of the employee, actually, so in this carrot, it is nothing but the reward or penalties. Okay, so if we put some reward points in front of the employees, then they will motivate, then they will get the motivation from this, and to get this reward, they will try to complete their work in given time. Okay, or they will work effectively or efficiently. Okay, so this is what about your carrot and stick theory. So here carrot refers to the incentives, and Stick refers to the penalties. Penalties, okay. Then next final one is what you are? Maslow's theory of motivation. Okay. Now here the scientist Abraham Maslow, he's well renowned for proposing the hierarchy of needs theory in 1943. So hierarchy, it means what? The step-by-step reward system is there, step-by-step promotion is there. So step-by-step promotion should be there in any in all organizations. To get this promotion, the employee need to work efficiently or effectively. Okay, so this theory has given by this Abraham Maslow in 1943. Okay, so Maslow was of the view that needs have priority, that is, needs are satisfied in an order. Okay, so there are basic needs of the basic need of the humans, then there are some priority based needs are there, then there are some wealth based needs are there for the all human beings. Okay, so as soon as the lower level needs are satisfied, those on the next higher level emerge. Okay, it means what? There are some levels: first level, second level, third level. So basic level needs, middle level needs, higher level needs. There are three types of the needs. So if the first level is satisfied, then the employee or this human try to achieve the second level. Okay, so what are these levels and how these employees are trying to achieve these levels, in this theory we will see. So thus Abraham considered an individual's motivation behavior as a predetermined order of needs. Okay, so there are, so hierarchy of needs theory, that is, so first one is what? Basic or physiological needs for any human being. That, so first basic needs, what are the basic needs for any human being? Is the food, water, air, shelter, sleep. Okay, so these are the basic needs of any human being. So these basic needs are satisfied by any employee with the help of his salary, then he will try to achieve the next level needs. So next level needs is what? Safety needs. Okay, so here security of job and need for predictable, secure and safe environment. Okay, so first basic needs are satisfied, then the employee will try to secure his job by doing efficient work or effective work. Okay, so these are the safety needs. So this employee will work efficiently, effectively to secure his job. Okay, or to get a safety environment. Okay, so this is the second level. Then third need is what? Social need. So social needs are needs for belongingness, needs for friendship, love, affection, attention and social acceptance. So these are the another needs. So to satisfy all these needs, he need to increase his salary or he need some extra income. So that's why he will do effective or efficient work to achieve promotion in the next level. So employee will try to get promotion in next level. So these are the social needs. Then next one is what? Esteem needs. So esteem needs, it means what? Reputation, prestige, power, status, recognition and respect of the others. Okay, so he will try to achieve all the prestige, all the respect when he will get promoted to the next level. So these are the levels or needs. Based on the needs, the levels are increased. Then finally, the self-actualization needs. Okay, so desire for gaining more knowledge, social service, creativity. Okay, so there in organization there are levels. By getting promotions, he will be promoted to the next level. Means what? First junior supervisors, then supervisor, assistant supervisor, then supervisor, then assistant manager, then manager, then will be the departmental manager, branch manager. Okay, so these are the levels. So depending on the needs, these levels should be satisfied by all the employees by doing effective or efficient work. Okay, so these are the needs or hierarchy of needs which is given by the Abraham Maslow. Okay, now next mode is what? Your communication. So communication, it is the process by which two or more persons come together to exchange ideas and understanding amongst themselves. Okay, so communication should be there to exchange more ideas among the people. Okay, so communication actually it is the basic organizational function which refers to the process by which a person transmits information or message to another person. Okay, so with the help of this communication, the employees will transfer their ideas or their information to the next level. Okay, so there should be a proper communication between the employees to have good idea or good suggestions. Okay, so why communication is needed? Communication is needed to share knowledge and information. First thing is what? To share knowledge and information. To present the ideas, the communication is needed. To influence others, proper communication should be there between the manager and employees. To influence the people, to motivate the people, we need a proper communication between the manager and employees. Then to build the relationships, okay, we need proper communication. To express the emotions, also we need a communication. Then for group system, to achieve the common objectives, okay, we need to express our ideas or we need to express our different suggestions based on the solution. Depending on the problem, we need to suggest different ideas how to overcome this solution. So we need this communication. Then to ensure effective completion of the task. Okay, to execute the completion of task means we need to have some communication, proper communication between the group. Then to reach a common understanding, we need also a communication. To share common values or systems, to build relationships, we need proper communication or proper channel between the peoples. Okay, so there are modes of the communication. Now, what are the different modes of the communication? So what are the types of the communication? So types are what? Written, oral and kinesics. Okay, so in written, it means there are example. For example, written communications include letters, memos, reports, etc. Okay, and usefulness of this report, this type of communication is what? It is relatively permanent and accessible. Okay, now oral communication, it will include conversations, interviews, phone calls, speeches, etc. And its usefulness is what? It is easiest when one needs to communicate urgently. Okay, when urgent communication is required, then this oral communication type is very important. Then finally, the third one is what? Kinesics. So this is nothing but facial expressions, actions or tone. And what is this usefulness of this? The body unconsciously does 90% of the communication. Okay, in this, so there are three modes of the communication. First one is what? Your written. Second one is your oral, and third one is your kinesics. Okay, now there are two main types: formal communication and informal communications. Okay, so formal communication, actually this communication takes place through the formal channels of the organization structure along the lines of authority established by the management. Then such type of communication is called as formal communication. So formal communication, it means what? The communication should be done through a proper channel with the help of established authorities. Okay, such communications are generally in written. Writings and may take any of the forms, that is policy, manuals, procedures and rule books. Okay, so it should be an official communication with the help of writings. Then in informal communication, it means what? The communications arising out of all those channels of communications that fall outside the formal channels is known as the informal communication. That is, informal communication does not flow lines of authority as is the case of formal communication. Okay, actually it arises due to the personal needs of the members of the organization. Okay, and at times in informal communication, it is difficult to fix responsibility about the accuracy of information. So such communication is usually oral and it may be covered even by simple glance or simple or silence. Okay, so these are the two types, formal and informal. So in formal communication, there should be a proper authorities or proper direction or proper channel should be there between the peoples or managers. Okay, and informal communication, it is opposite to this formal communication. Okay, so in this way we have covered this communication part. Now in next lecture, okay, so how to be effective in communication, next part is what? How to be effective in communication or what are the importance of the communication. Okay, so communication helps employees to understand their role clearly and perform effectively. So why the communication should be there? So because of this, the employee will get a clear plan or clear idea. Okay, the next one is what? It helps in achieving coordination and mutual understanding, which in turn leads to increased productivity. Okay, so if the ideas are clear, if the basic plans are clear, then the productivity of that employee will be increased. And communication improves the managerial efficiency and ensure cooperation of the staffs. Okay, so by proper communication, the coordination between the manager and staff will be maintained. Then effective communication helps in molding attitudes and building up employees' morale. Okay, so with the help of this communication, we will achieve the motivational task or inspirational task towards the employees. Okay, so these are the important points towards the communication. Okay, so in next lecture we will see the coordination, that is last element of the directing, that is this is nothing but your coordination. Okay, so here we will stop our lecture. Thank you.